Oh, hey. I've just been using the new Muse Athena. Haven't heard of it? Well, that's a shame, because the new Muse Athena is actually cool. Let me explain. My name is Hesham, and I'm a medical doctor, and as such, I'm always really keen to try new gadgets that offer new insights into the inner workings of our body. So you can guess I was pretty excited about getting my hands on the new Muse Athena, which is the much or long-awaited update to the Muse S that was released all the way back in 2021. So it's usually a good sign when a company spends 4 years developing the next iteration of their product. But to be perfectly honest, I was still a little bit cautious about the Athena, because Muse does make some pretty bold claims about their headbands, claiming they can help improve your meditation, your sleep, and even your focus. So can this headband really help you do all of that? Well, actually, yes. And to explain why, we need to stop by talking about the 2021 Muse S and why the Athena is such a radical and a wonderful development for these headbands that leaves me feeling really excited about the next generation of brain tech. So both the Muse S and the Athena use 4-channel EEGs to read your brainwaves. And brainwaves, they come in all different kinds of flavors. You have alpha, beta, delta, and theta waves. These waves represent the combined electrical activity of all the neurons firing in your brain at any moment in time, measured through the electrodes in the Muse headbands that are placed across your forehead and behind your ears. That's what both the 2021 Muse S and the 2025 Muse Athena have in common. So I guess the question is, what makes this one so different then? The magic word that you're looking for is infrared. Or if you're feeling extra pretentious just like me, it's functional near infrared spectroscopy, or just fNIRS for short. Pick your favorite. So near infrared light is a topic that's a little bit dear to my heart. And if you think I'm joking, I'm actually not. I actually make a point to teach near infrared light to the kids I teach university prep biology classes to, because I think infrared light is cool. Very cool. Which makes it the coolest thing ever, because I said so. So most people don't really understand or care to understand the difference between near and far infrared light, because most people think all infrared light is all the same. But it's not, because unlike visible light, which only occupies a range of 500 nanometers, that's all the different colors that you see around you, 500 nanometers on the electromagnetic wave spectrum, infrared light has a wavelength range of around a million nanometers, or 2,000 times more than that of all of visible light. All this to say that the applications of infrared light can vary substantially depending on whether we're dealing with near or we're dealing with far infrared light. And the Muse Athena, it makes use of near infrared light. And this allows the Athena to venture into completely new territory in wearable brain tech by actually visualizing how hard your brain is working at any given moment in time. It does this by using near infrared light to measure the blood oxygenation levels, so your prefrontal cortex, while you're doing different kinds of tasks. So some of you who've been subscribed to this channel for a while might remember me showing you these two images before. The images show a person who's never played Tetris before, playing Tetris for the very first time, versus that same person after they spent weeks playing Tetris every single day. Notice how the amount of oxygen decreases with training. Initially, you might think that makes no sense, but you need to remember that the more that you do something, the more that your brain adapts to that thing. Your brain is neuroplastic, and it can become more efficient at the tasks that you train it for, thereby requiring less oxygen. So after a few weeks of playing Tetris, you end up playing Tetris just as well, or actually more likely even better than you previously did, despite your brain needing to work less hard. Get some real-time data on that, on just how hard your brain is working any given moment in time, which reflects how focused you are while you're doing a particular task. Muse S, for all of its wonderful virtues, simply can't do that. It can track your brainwaves, and it does that pretty well, but the Athena monitors your brain's neurovascular responses in real time. When combined with the EEG readings, this gives you a multi-dimensional view into your mental state, which I think is nice.
All right!
We did it, yeah!
So both the Muse S and the Athena include other sensors as well. With both devices, you'll get a PPG heart rate sensor, an accelerometer, and a gyroscope for sensing movement, and a sleep position and a stillness tracking sensor. The Athena's PPG heart rate sensor gets an upgrade that allows for full SpO2 tracking, which besides telling you how focused you are, can provide you with a ton of useful information if you're trying to meditate or you're trying to sleep. You can use the Athena to get insights about sleep apnea. You can use it to monitor and track your respiratory quality, and the data that the Athena collects can help you better understand how your body and your brain recover overnight following different types of activity. So, that's a lot of valuable health data for you to get your hands on. And the Muse Athena sweetens the deal even further by upgrading the electrodes you get on the device to silver thread electrodes that are woven directly into the fabric, as I hope you can see here. These threads that you see here are actually made out of 20% silver, which might seem extravagant. Perhaps it is. But for lack of a better word, there is a silver lining here, as it turns this device into a clinical grade device. The silver thread electrodes will ensure that you get more consistent readings that give you an accurate picture of what's going on in your brain night after night after night. And when combined with the Athena's 14-bit resolution EEG sensors, a huge upgrade by the way from the Muse S 12-bit resolution EEG sensors, the Athena is guaranteed to give you more precise readings with fewer artifacts, so you can get more engaged with your Muse device and more immersed in the curated meditation, relaxation, and focus experiences that are provided through the Muse app. Which actually happens to be my biggest disappointment with Muse. Don't get me wrong. The app is wonderful. It's great and it has plenty of CBT-style exercises and experiences that will likely save a lot of people a bunch of therapy money. But as someone who avidly dislikes their smartphone and sees it primarily as a work device that brings nothing but stress and anxiety into my life, you need to calm down. I really wish there was a way to use Muse without needing a smartphone, which I know is a big ask, but it does feel odd having to use what is arguably the biggest source of anxiety in my life to relax. Anyway, I doubt most people hate their smartphones as much as I do, so I think most people will be okay with using the app. Perhaps I'm just being a geriatric boomer.
A sexy geriatric boomer, that is.
I'm speechless, so I don't know what to say.
But a boomer nonetheless. Some of you watching this video may already own the Muse S, in which case you might be wondering if you should upgrade. And generally I'm not a huge fan of upgrading, because I tend to be the person who uses older tech devices until they've successfully murdered them, and then I upgrade. But that said, the Muse Athena comes with so many cool new sensors and upgrades that it makes a very compelling case, especially if what you want to do is more than just track your meditation and your sleep. If you're looking to really step up your game and begin training your mind like a muscle, consider upgrading to the Athena. You won't regret it, most probably, and it'll be much more in line with what your needs are. So, I'm actually contractually obligated by Muse to tell you guys that 77% of users had better stress management after using Muse. 78% of users reported being calmer and more relaxed. 72% had better focus and clarity, and 71% had better emotional regularity. But these numbers are a little bit meaningless, at least in my opinion. So let me share a personal anecdote with you guys that I feel really helps get the point across why these devices are awesome. The truth is, well, I'm a fucking nightmare. I would literally lie in bed awake at 5 a.m. riddled with anxiety that's eating me alive, overthinking and analyzing something that happened literally 22 years ago that is of no consequence now. And no matter what I do, I just can't get my brain
to shut the fuck up.
There's this never-ending stress-inducing narrative that's running inside my brain at all times, all the time, every day, Christmas Day, New Year's Day, all the time. It's exhausting. So yes, my life is fun. Well, all that stress actually got me sick, and I ended up spending a couple of days at the hospital as I was receiving treatment for an autoimmune disease, Guillain-Barré syndrome, if you're wondering, which was kind of scary and stressful. But I guess the interesting thing was, because I'd been doing the Muse exercises before I was hospitalized, I felt I was much better able to manage my stress levels during my hospital stay. And I actually did manage to get some sleep during the days I was at the hospital for, which if you've ever tried sleeping in a hospital ward before, you will know is some kind of miracle. And I think that's what people don't really get about these devices. People I've spoken to seem to have this weird idea that you'll buy one of these and you'll wear them for the rest of your life. But no, that's not the point. You buy these for the sensors and the feedback and the data so you can better engage with the app exercises and the training programs. These headbands aren't a gadget, they're not a gimmick, they exist to train your mind, making you more resilient. And after using them for a really long time, you'll probably get to a point where you won't need them anymore because they've served their purpose. And personally, I think that's a compelling value proposition. This video is of course sponsored by Muse, so thank you to Muse for sponsoring this video, and thank you for making the time I spent at the hospital just a little bit more bearable. I plan to try the Athena a little bit more over the next few weeks, and then we'll be posting an update video then. In the meantime, if you'd like to get yourself a pair, either of the Muse S or the Athena, visit choosemuse.com/neuroeverything and make sure to use the neuroeverything discount code. You'll find the QR code on the screen and a link in the description below. In our next in-depth review, we'll be heading to the sleep lab and looking at how the Muse Athena can offer you improvements in your sleep. So that's something to look forward to. Thank you all for watching, and see you all next week.